As of April 14th of 2024, there are currently 47 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet. One of these erupting volcanoes is Ecuador's Fernandina Shield volcano, which had a lava flow reach and enter the Pacific Ocean on April 7th. As a result, a lava delta was created, and in the week since, it has expanded to 9.9 acres in size. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Indonesia, there is increased evidence that an active magmatic intrusion is ongoing at Mount Awu, the historically most lethal volcano in eastern Indonesia. Elsewhere in Japan, an increase in earthquakes along with fresh ground deformation was detected at the Kuchinoerabujima volcano, causing its alert level to be increased. And, in what is this week's top story, what initially appeared to be a brand new explosive eruption from Italy's Mount Etna volcano left behind a brand new 90-meter or 295-foot-wide crater on its summit. This crater formed within the southeast portion of a larger Boca Nuovo crater when, at 3:09 p.m. local time on April 7th, tremor at the volcano suddenly increased and a plume of ash rose into the sky. This plume reached a height of 5 kilometers or 16,400 feet, seemingly signaling that Etna's eruptive activity had resumed after a 4-month hiatus. However, as strange as it might seem, Mount Etna did not actually erupt on that day. Instead, the brand new crater was formed by a combination of an upward migrating cavity reaching the surface and eating away underneath the crater, which would form due to hydrothermal alteration. At low silica composition volcanoes such as Kilauea or Mount Etna, a telltale sign that an apparent eruption plume was instead due to a crater collapse is the very color of the plume which is generated. Crater collapse plumes have a notable and unusual reddish-brown tint to them, while true ash plumes have a distinguishably gray color. The reason for this is that the red scoria naturally deposited around an active volcanic vent becomes part of the plume generated by a collapse. As strange as this might sound, an identical phenomena was witnessed during May of 2018 in Hawaii, when the crater of the Pu'u'o'o collapsed and produced this beautiful plume during Kilauea's flank eruption. However, only 3 days later, Etna did actually produce a brand new eruption as a small phreatic explosion originated from its southeast crater. Whether or not this minor activity turns into a more pronounced eruption is unclear, as only time will tell. Meanwhile, in Indonesia, I am growing increasingly concerned about ongoing unrest at Mount Awu, a volcano which has caused more than 11,000 fatalities due to its eruptions from lahars and pyroclastic flows since 1500. Mount Awu had been undergoing a slow inflationary trend since June of last year, which was interpreted to be the refilling of its magma chamber estimated to be at 3 kilometers depth. This magma chamber appears to have since become full, resulting in viscous andesite composition magma slowly rising towards the surface and reaching an estimated depth of 1 kilometer 2 months ago. Since then, the magma conduit holding this magma has continued to widen, causing additional material to fill the conduit and not moving much further upwards. However, in the last 4 days, earthquake activity has increased alongside a notable spike in ground deformation, which could indicate the upward rise of magma once again. If Awu was to erupt, the presence of its existing lava dome, in my opinion, could result in a high-end VEI-3 to low-end VEI-5 explosive eruption, since it acts like a natural plug which significant amounts of highly pressurized gas and magma could become trapped underneath. In Japan, the alert level was raised at the Kuchinoerabujima volcano on April 13th in response to a spike in both earthquakes and ground deformation at its Furudaki crater. Having last erupted in 2020, I suspect the shallow rising magma to be the cause, meaning a small to medium-sized volcanic eruption could occur within the next several weeks. As a result, an exclusion zone was put in place on the island in a 2-kilometer radius of the Furudaki and Shindaki craters alongside a 1.1 nautical mile zone which was warned for waters surrounding the volcano. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on April 13th of 2024. As a final note, I would like to thank my channel's supporters on Patreon and via YouTube members.